Hey folks, welcome to Quantsapp and welcome back to yet another video. In this video, let's understand a simplified way of picking up high conviction trade ideas using open interest. So open interest, what does it tell you? Open contracts in which participants have interest in. Okay, so one thing whenever you are looking at futures or options open interest data, just keep in mind one simple thing, that open interest cannot be created by a single party. That means for a contract to get open, there has to be two parties involved. First one is the buyer and the seller. Okay, so for every contract, there is a buyer involved and there is a seller involved. So for every buyer, there has to be a seller standing, and for every seller, there has to be a buyer standing. Only then a open contract will get created. To put it very simple, let's say I want to create a contract, I want to buy it, but you don't want to sell it. Will there be a contract? No. So whenever you come across the term open interest, it involves two parties, buyer and the seller. Okay. So now when we combine open interest along with the movement of the price, that helps us in understanding, you know, the sentiments of the market, how they are creating the bets in comparison with the movement in the price. So now let's say for an instance, I am a buyer. Okay. I want to buy. That means I will try to buy at a price. Okay. And later on, I will sell it at a higher price. And that is how I will profit. On the other hand, for a seller who is selling it, he wants to sell it at a higher price. And when the price drops in the market later on, he will try to buy it back from the market. So now understand one thing. Say for an instance that there is a contract. Okay. Let's say there is a any stock wherein on the price was, let's say, 100 rupees. Okay, there was a stock on a specific day, the price was 100 rupees. You saw that the open interest of that particular script is going up. Okay, of futures, I'm talking about the futures, why it goes up. Then what happens is on the next day as well, the stock goes from 100 to 105. Even on this day, you see that the open interest, it is going up. So what is happening in this script? So the thing what is happening is there are fresh buyers who are buying it and there are sellers who are selling it. Now, any which ways, the seller will want to sell it at a higher price, obviously, right? But buyer, despite the stock has moved up, right, from 100 to 105, still is buying it. Why is buying it? Because he is expecting a continuation of up move. So this is called as long built up in the market. What happens in this scenario is that the price goes up along with the open interest going up. So in this case, if you see, the price is going up and the OI is going up. So there is active participation happening even in the rising prices. It is called as a long built up. So price and OI both go up in the long built up. So if you want to find out, you know, a bullish trend or a bullish stock, you see that that stock should have a lot of longs. Second thing is a short built up. So again, in this as well, OI will have both parties, buyers and sellers, both. So now let's say for an instance, there is a stock from 110, okay? It has slipped to, let's say, 105, okay? It slipped from 110 to 105. And you saw that the open interest of this stock is going up, meaning that there are buyers who have bought this contract and there are sellers who have sold this contract. So now the seller who is selling it is expecting a further down move to continue in the stock. Even on this day, let's say the price happens to be 800. And even on this day, if you see that the open interest is going up, that means there are buyers who are buying it and sellers who are selling it. Now, the seller who is selling it, he is important because he is expecting a continuation of down move. So even in the falling prices, seller is still confident enough and he's still going ahead and selling it. So now that tells us that this is a short built up happening in the market. The people, they are ready to go short on the market. So these are two types of built ups that we understood. So the first thing is long. What happens in a long built up is the price, it goes up along with OI going up. Short built up mein, the price goes down, but the OI goes up. That means people are selling it despite the prices which have fallen. So now you can navigate to built up tool in the application. You can navigate to script and navigate to symbol. Over here, you will get to see for all the scripts, what built up has been made. L indicates long. S indicates a short built up. SC indicates a short covering and LU indicates a long unwinding. So now what does long unwinding and short covering mean? So long unwinding is a temporary pause which might happen in a stock's bullish trend. Okay. So now what I mean by this is, so a stock hardly will go from directly from point A and stop directly at point B, right? The stock will always have those dips and then it will move in the upwards direction. So now what we need to find out is, let's say there is a long built up happening in the market, and then there is again a long unwinding move, then there is a long built up happening, and then again there is a long unwinding move. So basically this dips due to long unwindings, even these are healthy in the market, right? Even these are healthy kind of built ups happening. So the reason is because, you know, these longs, those are getting booked. Okay, so these dips in the market, those are just because of long positions getting unwinded. It is not due to a fresh short. The difference between a fresh short is that people are selling even more, but in this case, the existing longs are getting unwinded. So this is just a temporary pause which happens in a long trend. Similarly, on the short covering scenario, what would happen typically, the stock, this is how the stock will go down. So these up moves which are led by covering of existing shorts are called as short coverings. Okay, what happens in short covering is there is a temporary up move happening in the price, but this temporary up move, it is not because of a fresh long. Okay, it is because of existing short. Okay, existing short position getting covered. It is called as short covering. So now what I want in this scenario is, whenever, let's say, there is a move in the making. So what I want a stop to be on long and long unwinding cycle for a bullish setup, and I want a stock to be on the short and short covering cycle for a bearish setup to pick a high conviction trade idea using open interest. Now, if you would have looked at price standalone, the price would have kept on moving higher or lower. You wouldn't have known, okay, whether this is a fresh short built up happening or this is a short covering scenario. You wouldn't have known, right? But if you combine it along with open interest, you will learn to pick high conviction ideas. So let me show you a simple instance. So let's say I'll go to future OIH and let's select Bank Nifty. So this is showing us historical buildup. On what day, what buildup happened in Bank Nifty. The green color bars are showing us longs. The blues are showing us long unwindings. Reds are showing us shorts. Yellows are showing us short coverings. Okay, so let's just increase the period over here. Let's say 20, let's say July. You can select whatever data you want to see, have a look on. So just see this. What happened in this entire journey in Bank Nifty is, see what happened. There were longs. Long got booked. Longs. Long got unwinded. Longs. Longs got unwinded. From this day itself, wherein a typically where a trend had started. So how would you identify the trend has started? First, you need to, you know, wait. You need to wait for some longs to get created. Something like this. Then you need to wait for a dip, but this dip because of long unwinding. Okay. So you need to wait for a profit booking, and then you can try to optimize on, or I would say capitalize on that idea whenever Bank Nifty or whatever instruments you are trading, it takes a dip. So now let's say for an instance, you participate at 36,400. First significant short happened in the system at 40,700. So good up move what you enjoyed. So if you would have looked at price action as a standalone instrument, more likely is the chance you would have seen a lot of sell trades coming here, a lot of sell trades, you know, coming at a lot of place. But when you combine it with the open interest, now you know that this dip, it is just because of long unwinding. It is not due to fresh short. Your conviction to go long, it stays intact. Now let's say this short, you know that there is a dip in the market, but this dip is because of a fresh short. Okay, the time to get out of the long build up, right? So on this day, I'm not saying you will directly go short on the market, but at least your existing longs will be covered. Your existing longs will be exited. Similarly, just look at this. Okay. What happened? Short covering. And markets, they keep on moving lower. So now what we need to find is, so we need to find a very simple thing. So let's just note down. So we need to find out if I want to go ahead and participate on the long side. I want both long and long unwinding indicating a bullish trend. In our application in Quantsapp, you can simply find those out looking at by simple color codes, green plus blues, wherein the green indicates long buildup and the blue indicates long unwinding. Second thing is short plus short covering. Now, what does that indicate? A bearish trend. That means there are some up moves in the market, but those up moves are because of existing shorts getting covered. How will you find that out? Red plus yellows. Okay. So green and yellows indicate positivity. Reds and yellows caution you. Now, simple way of identification of trend is looking at the simple historical buildups in Quantsapp, which will tell you on what day what buildup was. And you know how simply it is put forward, that all you need to do is just look at the color codes, not a lot beyond that. Now, coming to, how can you find these things out? Okay. Let's say you want to find out all those stocks which are in a clear trend. Okay. And you want to find out high conviction ideas. Okay. Using the open interest. So how will you do that? So the idea is very simple. The process is very simple. You need to find out the moves which are in the making. Okay. You don't want to be the first one to participate, but you want to find out the moves which are in the making. So how you can do it? You can come to built up cycle. So this thing is showing you on what day, what built up happened, but it is showing you for all the stocks. Okay. So what you need to do is you need to set look back period as 20, because it considers almost, a complete month. Then set reading. What we want for a bullish trend? A long and long unwinding. So let's say long and long unwinding. Now the tool is asking us count. That means for how many days do we want long and long unwinding? Let's say 14. And then hit apply. Then looking at the simple color codes, you will find all those stocks which are in a clean uptrend. See Exide Industries, hardly any short built up. See About India, hardly any short built ups. Then you see IDFC, hardly any short built up. NMTC, few three shorts happening over here, but that is fine. Since then, since 21st of November, NMTC hardly, there is hardly any short built up happening in NMTC. Tata Steel, again, in a significant strength. So this is how you can identify stocks easily with help of open interest data. Just use future OIH, then you will see the historical data of that particular stock itself. See in Tata Steel, how significant the strength is, and stock is consistently moving in the upwards direction, right? And this dip, even these dips would have been bought and you would have made a good move from here itself. Then we come down to NMDC. Okay. So see, NMDC also looks lucrative, wherein it didn't witness any short built up since this day. The dips in the stock are out to long unwinding. So this is how you can easily find out the stocks which are in a clear trend. So now coming to cycle back, once again, if you want to find out the stocks which are on the short side, if you want to find out a negative idea using open interest, then you will use the 20 day data and find short and short covering at least for 14 days. See, all these are the stocks which are in a negative trend over here. So 20, okay, 14, long unwinding in cycle, 20, 14, short covering in cycle. This is how you can find out moves in the making. So other than that, you can combine these along with charts. Definitely you will, you can easily refine your trading ideas in one of the most simplest ways. So yes, folks, that was it from my side for this video. Thank you so much for joining me up till here. I hope I added some value to your trading, journey with this video. So stay tuned. See you all in the next video. Bye bye. Take care and happy trading.